Concerning the declaration of Christine Lagarde yesterday, I think there was mostly a problem of communication. The package of measures which has been put forward by the European Central Bank go in the right direction. Basically, they do three things. First, they increase the amount of the quantitative easing, so the amount of public bonds that could be bought by the European Central Bank. This is going to help us. And also, they increase the liquidity in the financial and banking system. So basically, what the European Central Bank has tried to do is try to keep banks floating and also supporting banks lending to the private sector. So they goes in the right direction. What was wrong, which I really think that is more a matter that Lagarde is an extremely extraordinary person, but she's not an economist. Probably she not realize which would have been the effect of declaring that the responsibility of the European Central Bank is not to take care of the spread, which is actually true, but this is true in normal time. In a moment like at the moment where stock markets are falling, there is a lot of uncertainty, there is the risk of creating multiple equilibrium in the financial market. So this is a moment in which Christine Lagarde should have said something like, "We are here to avoid that." The evaluation of public debt might go beyond what is the economic, what is based on economic fundament. But she also went back on her first declaration and whatever. So my view is that, I mean, basically the European Central Bank is doing what it was supposed to do. I mean, even all this debate about reducing interest rate when interest rate are already negative. At minus 5% doesn't really make much sense. So, a minus 0.5%. So I think that at the end, the European Central Bank is doing what it should have done. The real problem that there is monetary policy in this particular context is not enough. We also need to have fiscal policy. Fiscal policy is not so supporting the economy through the fiscal policy, which meaning spending or reducing taxing or supporting the economy in a way or the other. And this is what the Italian government is trying to do. But of course, this is the moment in which all European countries should do it at the same time, because this would support the economy. We are in a situation which is not very different from the financial crisis of 2009. In that moment, European country together support the economy, and we have to do exactly. I think that the easiest, the best thing to do would be to do something like an European program of public expenditure. I mean, there are not all countries have fiscal space, so they have the possibility to spend. But what we could do, we could also issue, for example, through the European Stability Mechanism, bonds which are backed by all the Euro country and use this money to support spending in European public goods. And what are these European public goods? The best at the moment is, of course, healthcare. And we should have a bit more of coordination on supporting healthcare. So I'm saying buying equipment, improving spending even more in terms of research and whatever. This is a collective. Clearly, this disease, this virus, is a collective threat for the European, for the Europe in general, and particularly for the European Monetary Union. It has to be faced at the same time. I think this is an existential threat for Europe, exactly because this is a collective challenge and has to be faced collectively. If Europe will not be at the level of the threat, this can be really dangerous for all the construction of the European project. But let me also add that I'm optimistic. The real problem in Europe is that we have a mechanism, institutions which do not work well. I mean, while if you look, for example, Monetary Union, there is a European Central Bank. The European Central Bank, if there is a problem, can act quickly and immediately. Instead, if you look on fiscal policy, what can be done? You have to think that it has to be decided by sovereign country. Sovereign country, we have to meet. 27 different countries which have to take a discussion, taking a decision, or whatever. And this, is, of course, takes time. There are some countries which are not convinced, some of them which still believe that maybe the virus is not to affect them, which is clearly a mistake. And so it takes time. And this is the part of the problem of Europe. It's a more a problem institution. One of the proposals which has been made in the past is to have an authority, a fiscal authority, which could coordinate fiscal policy more quickly among sovereign countries. And perhaps this crisis will be open the opportunity to create such an institution. But let's be optimistic. At the end, European countries and the European Union, I think, will deliver. Thank you.